Welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial. Riemann integration, one of the very important theorem for your end semester examination. Let us see the statement. If f belongs to capital R of a comma b and small m comma capital M are infimum and supremum of f on closed interval a comma b, then small m into b minus a less than or equals to integral a to b f of x dx less than or equals to capital M into b minus a. Let us see the proof of this theorem. One of the very important theorem for 10 mark section, as well as it is important for 5 mark section also. So given that f belongs to capital R of a comma b, f belongs to capital R of a comma b, it means this symbol stands for f is Riemann integrable, f is Riemann integrable over the closed interval a comma b. F belongs to capital R of a comma b. F belongs to capital R of a comma b means f is Riemann integrable over closed interval a comma b. A function f is said to be Riemann integrable over closed interval a comma b if integral a to b f of x dx is equals to lower Riemann integral integral a bar to b f of x dx is equals to upper Riemann integral integral a to b bar f of x dx. Let it be equation number 1. Equation 1 is nothing but the definition of a Riemann integrable function. A function f of x is said to be Riemann integrable over the closed interval a comma b if it satisfies the condition integral a to b f of x dx is equals to lower Riemann integral integral a bar to b f of x dx is equals to upper Riemann integral integral a to b bar f of x dx. Observe that. Right. Also given that small m is equals to infimum of f of x, small m is equals to infimum of f of x such that x belongs to closed interval a comma b. Small m is infimum of the function f and capital M is supremum of f of x such that x belongs to closed interval a comma b. By definition of infimum and supremum, it is very clear small m is less than or equals to capital M. Small m is less than or equals to capital M. Yes. To complete the proof of this theorem, let us take a partition. Let P is equals to A is equals to x0, x1, x2, and so on, xn is equals to B. Be a partition of closed interval A comma B. P be a partition of closed interval a comma b and take IR is equals to XR minus 1 comma XR be the rth sub interval of closed interval a comma b. Rth sub interval of closed interval a comma b, comma where R varies from 1 to and so on small n, and define one more term delta R is equals to length of the rth sub interval IR, length of the rth sub interval IR. Observe that delta R is equals to length of the rth sub interval IR, length of the rth sub interval IR, and define another two terminologies. Small mr is equals to infimum of f of x over the rth sub interval IR, comma R varies from 1 to and so on small m. Capital mr is equals to supremum of f of x over the same rth sub interval IR, comma R varies from 1 to and so on small m. Observe the terminology and these are very very important. Observe that P is a partition of the closed interval A comma B. IR is the arc sub interval. Delta R is the length of the arc sub interval. Small mr is infimum of f of x over IR. Capital mr is supremum of f of x over IR. Already we learned that small m is equals to infimum of f over closed interval A comma B. Small capital M is equals to supremum of f over closed interval A comma B. By using all these results, we can get a inequality like this. By using all these symbols, we get a inequality like this. Small m is less than or equals to small mr is less than or equals to capital mr is less than or equals to capital M. Delta R is length of IR. Length is always positive. Delta R is length of IR. Length is always positive. So multiply this inequality with delta R. Small m delta R less than or equals to small mr delta R less than or equals to capital mr delta R less than or equals to capital M delta R. Taking summation to this inequality and r varies from 1 to n. Summation r is equals to 1 to n small m delta r less than or equals to summation r is equals to 1 to n small mr delta r less than or equals to summation r is equals to 1 to n capital mr delta r less than or equals to summation r is equals to 1 to n capital m delta r. You observe that small m is independent of r, so it can be written as small m summation r is equals to 1 to n delta r. What is this summation r is equals to 1 to n small mr delta r? Is nothing but LPF, lower Riemann sum. LPF means lower Riemann sum. Summation r is equals to 1 to n small mr delta r. So it can be written as LPF. It can be written as LPF. Similarly, this term is nothing but UPF. UPF is equals to upper Riemann sum. Upper Riemann sum. Summation r is equals to 1 to n capital mr delta r. Which is less than or equals to UPF. Which is less than or equals to, again capital M is independent of r. So capital M into summation r is equals to 1 to n delta r. Already we learned that summation r is equals to 1 to n delta r is equals to b minus a. Already we learned that summation r is equals to 1 to n delta r is equals to b minus a. So from this inequality we get small m into b minus a less than or equals to LPF, less than or equals to UPF, less than or equals to capital M into b minus a. Let it be equation number 2. Already we take equation number 1, we learn that. Let it be equation number 2. Now let us see the definition of upper Riemann integral and lower Riemann integral. What is the lower Riemann integral? We know that the lower Riemann integral, integral a bar to b f of x dx is equals to supremum of LPF, supremum of LPF such that p belongs to pi of a comma b. Already we know that by the definition of lower Riemann integral, integral a bar to b f of x dx is equals to supremum of LPF such that p belongs to pi of a comma b. From this equality, if you remove the supremum, then you get LPF. If you remove the supremum, you get integral a bar to b f of x dx greater than or equals to LPF. That is, LPF is less than or equals to integral a bar to b f of x dx. From equation 1, what is equation 1? Lower Riemann integral is equals to upper Riemann integral. Integral a bar to b f of x dx is equals to इंटीग्रल ए टू बी बार एफ ऑफ एक्स डीएक्स इज इक्वल टू इंटीग्रल ए टू बी एफ ऑफ एक्स डीएक्स दिस इज द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन सो बाय यूजिंग दिस इक्वेशन नंबर वन इक्वेशन नंबर वन हियर एल पी एफ इज लेस देन आर इक्वल टू इंटीग्रल ए टू बी एफ ऑफ एक्स डीएक्स इक्वेशन नंबर थ्री एंड देन सिमिलरली LPF is less than or equals to integral a to b f of x dx. Similarly, you can prove that integral a to b f of x dx, integral a to b f of x dx is less than or equals to UPF. Is less than or equals to UPF. Equation number four. Now combining. Now combining equations. 3, 4, 2 we get. You observe that all the three equations are here. Now combining equation 2, 3 and 4 we get. Small m into b minus a less than or equals to LPF. And LPF is less than or equals to integral a to b f of x dx. Integral a to b f of x dx is less than or equals to UPF. Is less than or equals to capital M into b minus a. Now combining all the three equations we get. Small m into b minus a is less than or equals to integral a to b f of x dx is less than or equals to capital M into b minus a. This completes the proof of the theorem. Hence proved. Observe that if you know the definitions and results of Riemann integration, then it is very simple and easy. If you don't know the basics of this Riemann integration definition or partition or supremum or infimum or lower Riemann sum, upper Riemann sum definitions, then it is very difficult to understand. So first learn the basics, then the theorem will become very simple and easy. Keep learning. Wish you all the best.